Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our first ever Senior Music Awards evening. Normally, this would take place at our spring concert, and because of the pandemic, we have a video spring concert coming up that you'll get to see shortly. But we thought it would be nice to honor our seniors just the same by having this ceremony, so welcome. I'm going to ask everybody if you could please rise so that we can pledge allegiance to the flag, and if you have a hat, if you would remove it. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. We're going to get right to business. I'm going to introduce you to Kelly Drew, who is president of the Rotary Club of North Conway. She has graciously agreed to come here tonight to present the Rotary Milliman Award, and she has another meeting. So, Kelly, welcome. Please come. Room. Hopefully the next time we see each other, we won't have to wear these things. I've been a Rotarian for 30 years. The Rotary Club has been around since 1927, our club. And we do a lot of things in the area. I don't know if anybody's heard about Rotary, but if you're very interested in Rotary, feel free to reach out to us. We have meetings every week. But tonight, it's about giving out awards, and I want to extend my congratulations to all the seniors. You're graduating. Yes. I know it's been a long run. Last year was tough for you, and you have to go through it again this year. It's not easy. I can't imagine how it is, but you got to thank your parents and the staff for hanging in there with you, because we know that it is hard for you. This year, as always, we hand out the Milliman Award, and it's a person that we identify as somebody who has excelled in the musical field. And it's Mike Miller Dorji. Congratulations, Mila. First, I'd like to announce the Instrumental Music Academic Awards. They were given out a couple of weeks ago, but the students who received them couldn't be here. So I thought this was an excellent opportunity to acknowledge them in front of their peers and parents. So, Academic Awards for diligence in learning their instrument and marked growth over their years in the music program. On drums, Cody Hamlin. And on tenor sax, Cam Day. The next award I'd like to give out is a new one this year called the Heartstrings Award. Dolly Parton has stated that her songs are her heartstrings. This senior often expresses the powerful impact music has had in her life. She has made it clear that music is also her heartstrings. Her quiet ways and willingness to express her thoughts made her a natural pick for the first Heartstrings Award, Brooke Hargraves. The Ernie Mills Low Brass Award. This $100 award is named after a father and son who are both trombonists. The son, a KHS graduate, went on to become a music teacher himself. It is given to a brass player who contributes positively to the ensemble, one who exhibits a great attitude. That is the number one requirement. And this year's award is presented to Molly Damon. The National Louis Armstrong Jazz Award is given to a student who dedicates himself or herself to the study of jazz throughout his or her high school career. This year's recipient has worked tirelessly to master difficult jazz chords on her guitar, as well as playing mallets in our drumline. Please join me in congratulating Lily Barber. We created the Gene Fickett Eagle Spirit Award when longtime Mount Washington Valley educator and my mentor, Gene Fickett, retired. It is given to a student who demonstrates boundless enthusiasm for band, bleeds black and white throughout school, and in this case is a true friend to every member of the music program. Let's hear it for Brianna Consul. We're going to take a little break from the individual awards, and I'm going to ask all the senior members of the drumline to come up and stand across the front of the stage, please. It's a tradition when the drummers graduate to present them with these are our, the marching band sticks that we use, and we have them engraved with Kennett drumline. Let's hear it for the senior members of our family. So, as many of you know, it's been really hard on the musicians. Something special. We have had plaques made up for the listing all the names of the senior students, and the plaques will go in the trophy case. The plaques read, in special recognition of the 2020-2021 band seniors who contributed to the musical life of Kennett High School during the COVID-19 pandemic. And then each of their names has been listed. So we wanted to share that. The fact that these kids stuck it out when they weren't sure they were going to be able to sing and couldn't play for so long, really speaks to their commitment. So there it is. Okay. Next up, the National Instrumentalist Magazine Merit Awards. This award is given to students in recognition of outstanding contributions, leadership, and service to the school music program. This year, we have 4 deserving recipients. I'd like to announce them one at a time and have us acknowledge them one at a time. For exceptional fundraising in multiple years and for starting the Meet the Musicians initiative, Bobby Kraustein. Shortages that we've had in the band over the last several years, and volunteering to work on literally every project that came along, a real workhorse, please acknowledge River West. Tutor to Block One drummers and running many, many errands throughout the town on behalf of the drumline and the band, and also sharing her story for the benefit of others, Abby Weckesser. Juggling academics, athletics, and music, maintaining active status in the Tri-Am Music Honor Society, and for helping to ensure that the jazz program stayed alive during the pandemic, Sierra Parsons. Take a short break from the instrumental awards and let Mrs. Fougere come on up and give out the choral awards.
And with her assistant. This goes to a senior who has been in choir, although unfortunately this year classes were canceled because of the pandemic, but they were all signed up and ready to go. She has been singing the chamber choir, and I've really enjoyed having her in the program. So this year's Outstanding Senior Award goes to Gianna. Goes to a student who is dedicated to the musicianship of the choir and goes above and beyond the call of duty. They are often a section leader or a strong member of their section. They contribute to the success of the program and is a person the choir and director can depend on. And this year's musicianship award goes to Sierra. All right. This next award is the National School Choral Award. This is given to a choir member who is most involved in the choral repertoire through a variety of choral experiences, both inside and outside of school. It is a recognition of a student who has truly dedicated themselves to experiencing as much choral music in as many choirs as they've had the opportunity to try. This student should be in multiple choirs in and outside of school, a student who has auditioned for or been accepted to local and state music festivals, exhibits outstanding musicianship and ability, is highly dedicated to the program, whose leadership and contributions to any and all choirs in the school, and has strong academic achievement. It is my honor this year to give the National School Choral Award to Kaylee Wood. Exceptional choir member. Outstanding musicianship and ability. Exceptional dedication to the choir, choir events, and the development of the choir. Portrays qualities of leadership toward the choir as a section leader or as president, vice president of the choir. Shows high moral values and portrays high academic achievement, maintaining a 3.0 or higher grade point average. It is my honor to give this year's Director's Award for Chorus to Christina Solomon. I have missed you all terribly this year. I wish you were able to sing. Those of you that are around and you want to come sing the graduation song, message me, but thank you for all you've given to this program for the last 4 years. I will miss you all terribly. Thank you.
Quincy Jones Musicianship Award honors outstanding students for their creativity and musicianship. It is given to students who share this boundless energy and proficiencies in multiple areas of music. This year's recipient is known for playing the guitar, bass, piano, and drums, and I'm sure others that I just don't know because he hasn't played them around here. He arranges music. He records outside of school and has even recorded a solo album in his spare time, Mila Dorji. This is kind of fun now, now that I'm not so teary at missing them. They're not even gone yet and I miss them. The National John Philip Sousa Award recognizes superior musicianship and outstanding dedication. John Philip Sousa was the first bandmaster of the President's Own Marine Corps Band. This student served as our drum major, worked on multiple projects to help make the 2021 band experience special, and she has enlisted in the U.S. Army. Her name will be added to a national database of recipients of the National John Philip Sousa Award. Please join me in recognizing Kayla Boothby. The National Director's Award for Band honors an outstanding member of the high school band. This year's recipient has had an exemplary year and an outstanding four-year career. He demonstrated excellent leadership as one of our drum captains, and also demonstrated kindness in all aspects of his daily contributions to the drumline. Additionally, his musicianship improved each and every year, all the way through his senior year. I was taught very early on that there is no E at the end of his last name. Unfortunately, the engravers were not. So I'm going to give you your award, Mr. Gavitt, this evening, but I'm going to get it back so I can have the plaque properly engraved. But congratulations on receiving the National Director's Award for Gavitt. There is a music department alumni Facebook page. Now, I know Facebook is not for the young, but I would appreciate it if each and every one of you joined the alumni Facebook page so that you can keep up on what's going on here and occasionally tell us what's going on in your lives as well, okay? And this brings us to the last individual awards this evening. Just double checking. The National Semper Fidelis Award is announced on Academic Awards Night each year, but we are presenting it tonight. It is designed to recognize a young man and a young woman, distinguished high school band members for musical achievements and leadership as a high school scholar. Candidates should be exemplary young citizens and role models for other students. This program is sponsored by the United States Marines Youth Foundation, Incorporated. The award recipients may be those who were most inspirational or showed the greatest determination. The requirements include: be a high school senior, be capable of performing as a soloist with a high school band, and be recognized as both an outstanding performer and as a truly outstanding young citizen. They must also devote time to the extracurricular needs of the band. And this year, the awards go to Haley Young and Thomas True. We also have Tri-M Music Honor Society certificates for the seniors who did maintain their grade point average. They will be able to pick up their certificates. We also have their stoles, the Tri-M stoles for graduation students. We're not just given the stoles, they had to earn them. They had to participate in either two service projects or regularly attend Tri-M meetings and one service project. So their names are on their stoles. It's still not too late. If your son or daughter hasn't earned their stole yet, they have a week and a half left to get it done. And we also have, for the members of our honors choirs and the jazz band, we have the pink cords that they get to wear at graduation as well. We don't usually hand those out. We just have everybody pick them up. If you are missing any of your awards points, regalia from over the years, please do see me to get them. We do have the medals and the pins and all the other things for you. This concludes our award ceremony this evening. We invite you to get a cupcake and some punch and head out to the green behind the auditorium for some social time. Thank you, parents, for the support that you've given me and Mrs. Fougere and the music program. This does not conclude the event. I should have written it down. It wasn't on my cheat sheet. We have two things to do left, and then it is concluded, and one of them is obviously a musical presentation. I should have put it on my list. I have asked one of our senior class members, who is, in my opinion, the best friend of everybody in the program, to say a little something to you tonight from the perspective of our student body. So please welcome to the microphone, Brianna Constant.
Hi everyone, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Brianna. Peter just said that. I'm a senior in band and drumline, and I started my band and drumline in my freshman year. And while I've never been the best at my instruments, these ensembles have been one of the highlights of my years at Kennett. The community, the performing arts department provided will always be one where we all belong. And I'd like to thank you all for creating a space where we can all thrive and grow, both musically and as people. I know this year was especially hard for the music department, both on the instrumental and choral side, and this is a disappointing note to leave off on, but we all did great, and we'll continue to do great as we begin the next chapter of our lives. Congratulations and good luck to all the seniors. And most of all, thank you to the parents for supporting us and helping us make these things happen. And thank you to T-Dave and Holly for guiding us.
I am so glad that I told her to make sure I didn't forget to have that happen. She was waving at me going, T-Dave. So now I'm going to invite the jazz band seniors to the stage. Mila and Haley worked very hard on an arrangement of My Life, Billy Joel's My Life, and the seniors would like to perform that for you now, and that will conclude our awards ceremony this evening.
They've done so much to support us and to make sure that we still get to carry on with our music journeys, even though this year has been insane. So we have flowers and cards.
Setting up, I'm just going to say one thing about this, Miss Christina Solomon. Christina was our Tri-Am Music Honor Society president this year and did the yeoman's work for everything Tri-Am. She took a load off my plate at each and every week. I cannot thank you enough for your hard work this year. You were outstanding.
Thank you.
So let's have some cupcakes and some punch. Thank you very much for coming out, everybody.